This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to do a proof that the square root of 2 is an irrational number. And then at the end of the video, I'm going to show you how you might be able to do a proof that any root of any prime number is an irrational number. But let's start out with the square root of 2. So I've got the square root of 2, and I want to prove that it's irrational. Now, I'm going to do this by what we call a proof by contradiction. In other words, I'm going to try to prove that the square root of 2 is rational. And then if I can't do that, that will mean it's an irrational number. So I'm going to write the square root of 2 equals a over b. Now, remember, a rational number is a number that I can write as the ratio of two integers. Or in other words, it's a number I can write as a fraction. So I'm saying that the square root of 2 equals a over b. I'm assuming that the fraction a over b is reduced to its lowest terms. In other words, the numbers a and b don't have any common factors because the fraction has been reduced. Okay, so I've got the square root of 2 equals a over b. I'm going to get rid of my radical sign by squaring both sides. So when I square the square root of 2, I just get a 2. And when I square a over b, I get a squared over b squared. And now I can multiply both sides of this fraction, 2 equals a squared over b squared, by b squared. And I'm going to have 2b squared equals a squared. Now let's stop a second to make sure we understand what this implies. If 2b squared equals a squared, that means a squared must be divisible by 2 because we multiplied some number, b squared, in order to get a squared. And if a squared is divisible by 2, then a has to be divisible by 2. So over on the side here, I'm going to write 2 divides a. So remember, if 2 is divisor of a, if 2 divides a, then that means there's some number that I can multiply by 2 in order to get an a. So I'm going to call that number k. I'm going to say that a equals 2k. Okay? Now I'm going to go back to this 2b squared equals a squared, and I'm going to rewrite that. I'm going to have 2b squared, and instead of a squared, I'm going to replace the a with 2k. So I'm going to have 2k in parentheses, and I'll square that. When I do the squaring, I get 2b squared equals 4k squared. And of course, I can divide both sides of this fraction by 2, both sides of this equation by 2, and I'm going to get b squared equals 2k squared. Well, if b squared equals 2k squared, that means b squared is a number that could be divided by 2. And that means that b is a number that could be divided by 2. So 2 divides b. I already said that 2 divides a. Well, if 2 is a divisor of both a and b, then my first assumption that a over b is a fraction reduced to lowest terms, that assumption's wrong. Because what we're saying is that I could divide a 2 into both a and b, so they have a common factor. Since that assumption was wrong, that means this whole proof falls apart, and I'm not able to prove that the square root of 2 equals a over b. So I'm not able to prove that it's a rational number. So therefore, that means the square root of 2 is an irrational number. Now, if you're comfortable with that idea, what you might want to think about is that we could extend this proof in a general way. We could say that any root, let's call it the nth root of any prime number, I could try to say that that's rational. And if I try to do that, in other words, if I say the nth root of some prime number p equals a over b is a rational number, that proof is going to fall apart in the same way that my proof for the square root of 2 fell apart. And so therefore, you could show that the nth root of whatever prime number you take is going to be an irrational number. Okay, so that's the basic proof. You might want to run through this a couple of times, work it out on paper for yourself. It's not a very hard proof, but sometimes it takes a while to get your head around it. Okay, that's it for now. Take care. I'll see you next time.